In this video, we are going over the ventricle model, which is the gray structure in the upper right, but we're going to show you the orientation of where it actually sits in your brain. So we're going to go ahead and zoom in on the brain model, and we know the major structures of the ventricle model are going to be the lateral ventricles, which is this sits in this area right through here. We're going to have the third ventricle, which is this circular area right through here, and we're going to have the cerebral aqueduct, which leads from the third, from the third to the fourth, and the fourth is going to be where the letter E is. And so we know that the ventricles are just going to be cavities where cerebral spinal fluid or CSF flows. So if we could freeze it and pull it out, you'd see it where this is where it actually looked like, the ventricle space would actually look like on the ventricle model. So we're going to go to the superior view. And on the superior view, you're going to see that there is going to be the left lateral ventricle, the right lateral ventricle, and now we're going to go to the lateral view. But before we go there real quick, I want you to know that these two halves are separated by the septum pellucidum. Okay, so let's go ahead and go to the lateral view. And on the lateral view, you're going to see that there's 50, 51, 49, 47, but so let's talk about those numbers. So the first one we see is going to be 49, and that is the lateral ventricle. And so you're thinking, Annie, do I just mean this? But no, I actually mean all three of these structures, okay? So you have the posterior horn, the inferior horn, but these two horns are a part of this whole lateral ventricle, okay? That's even including up through here, okay? All right, and so we have 51, which we know is the interventricular foramen. And this is, remember, it's in the name, so it's letting you know it's connecting these two ventricles. It's connecting the lateral to the third. And the third is going to be number 50, and it's going to include this little hole, this whole area right through here. And remember, this is what 19 and 20, that little space I was just rubbing on the actual brain model is. And so we're wondering what this little hole is, and that little hole that's back here that I'm about to stick this through, this is going to be the position where the intermediated mass or the interthalamic adhesion sits, which is why it's not filled with cerebral spinal fluid. So we're going to go ahead and go that note that 47 is going to be the cerebral aqueduct, right? And it's flowing from the third down here, and there should be a number 48 right through here, but we know that this is going to be 48, and this is going to be the fourth ventricle. So quick review, 49 is going to be the lateral ventricle. 51 is going to be the interventricular foramen that connects the lateral to the third. 50 is going to be the third ventricle, this whole little structure here. 47, which you can see down the back right there, is going to be the cerebral aqueduct, which connects the third down here to the fourth.